me doing, Mom? Doing, just doing all I do is do right? What's wrong, preacher? I'm gonna do right. I'm saved by the grace of God, filled with the Holy Ghost of God. God's called me to preach. I'll always do right. There'll not be no problem with me doing right. Doing right's not going to be the problem. Getting people to follow me and winning people to God's going to be the hard thing. So I need some advice about how, what process, is there some other tool that I need? What Bible, I'll have the right Bible, but give me some commentaries, give me some literature, give me some resources to where I can study and be more powerful in preaching.
Advice again. Three words this morning, and I'll be done. Brother John's going to have to be a leader. Because when you get ordained and you become a preacher, people look up to you. Sort of leadership, you got to have a good education. Sometimes that's hard to do right. Because us Baptists, what I just read is that brawling thing. Sometimes as preachers we have an issue with this stuff that we call flesh. Because it gets under our skin. And guess what? I didn't have but one nerve, and guess what? The church member got on. Some other person got on my last nerve. Because us preachers are human also, just like everybody. But nobody ever expects us to be human. Because we're held to a higher standard. Not just people that hold us to a higher standard, but God holds us to a higher standard. And matter of fact, He holds us to the highest. And I have learned in the ministry. I'm not off the police him before I please the world. As long as I please him and do right, everything else will smooth out. And to be a leader sometimes, you kind of have to eat crow. Sometimes you have to be, when you're right, you have to even admit that maybe you're wrong. Even Jesus was right. And they nailed him to Calvary. He laid his life down. And he was right. To be a leader sometimes, it's going to be a hard thing to do. Because God holds us to a higher standard. But then, second of all, we're not just leaders. All right? But we have to be loyal to the call. Sometimes I have found out that people just don't understand this. Why? Because it's a calling. It's not a position. It's something that God puts down in your soul. It's just shut up in our bones. We wake up in the middle of the night preaching to ourselves. We get up in the morning preaching to ourselves. We're at lunchtime and we're writing on a piece of napkin because we've got to preach on Wednesday, or we've got to preach on Sunday, and we've got a napkin and we don't have really a piece of paper. Or we wrote a message on our hand that God just spoke to us about. We're almost kind of loony, really. I mean, really. People think that we're just kind of crazy. You have to be loyal. Some people just don't understand. Why? Because it's a call. Because everybody don't be called. And they don't understand some, even the degree of stress and depression and all the things that goes along with being loyal to the Lord Jesus Christ and being a leader and having your testimony and trying your very best to do right in front of people. And first of all, and foremost, we're trying to please God in all that we do. We're trying to please people. We're trying to please God. We're trying to please our families. We're trying husbands are trying to do right by their wives and their children. And we've got all of this, and it's all on our plate. Plus, we've got the calling of God. Sometimes that's what we're trying to do, is to be loyal. It's hard to be loyal to the Word of God when we're tired. When we work 60 hours. And all we want to do is lay down and get us just a cat nap, man. Just give me a power nap. Just let me pull off to the side of the road. Man, I've done that. If I had a dollar for every time I pulled off the side of the road just to get a power nap where I could just read a few verses. Man, I tell you, I wouldn't need an offering today. Sometimes we have to force ourselves to do right, to be loyal to the cause. Because I believe there was someone that said in the Word of God, is there not a cause? I mean, just a young boy made such a powerful statement. A powerful statement. Says, is there not a cause? And sometimes we feel like we're the only one in that boat. We're fighting on. We're the only one in the boat. And we're the only one that's got the problem. And we're the only one that's dealing with the issue. And nobody understands. If I said that one time, I said it. But I found out one thing. Lord, nobody else understands. And he'll send reinforcements. And reinforcements. We just have to be patient enough to wait. We just have to be patient enough to wait on the reinforcements. So first of all, he has to be loyal to the cause. He has to display leadership. This is a thug. Always say the best for last. Because Jesus is. Because you know, he don't say the best for last. We're not in the building business. We're not in the Sunday school business. We're not in the chicken plate business. We're not in the barbecue business. We're in the people business. You know why? It'd be all right, Brother Randy. What's this? Brother Mike, some of you other preachers. Wouldn't it be wonderful? Wouldn't it be wonderful if we could just get our salary taken care of on Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night, and didn't have to deal with people? I come back here because I may have to duck. It'd be fine if all we had to do was serve God and please Him. I'd be wonderful if we just had to work for the captain of the ship. And all the one that we had to please was God. But the Lord Jesus Christ, He didn't die for no temple. He didn't die for the tabernacle. He died for people. He didn't die for a building, my friend, that a lot of us call a church of four walls, but the church is not the four walls. It is the people that's the church. And that's what the Lord Jesus Christ died for. He died for people. And people give us the biggest problem. Now, you preachers, don't bow your head. It ain't time to pray. Some of you church members is right there, right here behind me. It's your pastor right here. And Jesus died for people. And these men right here have to deal with people all the time. They have to deal with not just you, but other people. People at work that's lost and undone without God. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to reach them. And they're maybe in 3 or 4 different counties away. They're not going to come and pay tithes at our church. They're not going to put up a tent. They're not going to cut the grass or weed either, clean out the toilet. But that's a calling.
when we run into somebody that's lost and undone and gone dying and going to hell. My friend, I assure you, let me just run this rabbit right quick. If God would allow hell to open up just a crack, our lives would change that quick. If we could just experience what hell was like for just a few seconds. Not for us to be there, but just experience the hell that's in hell. Our lives will change overnight. I assure you, you would not want your family sitting at the house or at the flea market. Or even at the restaurant. That's the calling on what's on a preacher's life. And that's not just a calling. That should ought to be in all of us. But it's really in us preachers. Oh, we don't want to go back. We've read the back of the book and we know who we are. But there's some parts and pieces of this little book right here that we don't want nobody to drink.
No, the goose is just like tags. No,
just one or two is all I have.
You say, that's that goose.
Actually, I've got more.
No.
But I wouldn't want more. Can you put some of it here? We're not just ordained and preachers. They ought not to be mentioned. This is your way of sending me out. From here on out, I'm going to do my best to do right. And sometimes when you do right, it even looks like a devil. It even feels like a devil. That same preacher told me right's right.
Oh, I didn't know.
Mommy, there's Toto. Toto's here. Let's play duck goose.
The Lord displayed leadership. And nobody else wants to take the place. Lord, we live in a society today that nobody wants to take the place. All comes from blood. There's a lot of pain that goes along with picking up the bloodstained back. It's not all a bed of roses. God, you said if we suffer with you, we'd also reign with you. Well, that's a promise. It's not just a command, but that's a promise from you. There's probably not a Christian under this tent this morning, God, that's not experienced some kind of pain, suffering. If it be physical, emotional, spiritual, there'd be not a person that could not raise their hand and say, preacher, I've made some mistakes. I've had some failures. I've had some spiritual pain. I've had some emotional pain. I've had some disappointments in my life. And it's been hard sometimes just to do right. Just to be loyal to come to church. Not to do anything much. But just to get up on Sunday morning and come to church. Be back there on Sunday night. Lord, there's all kind of things, God, that tears us in all kind of different directions. It makes our mind go to here and goes there. Our emotions get out of whack. God, help us to just be focused on doing right. God, help us to manage our time, God, that you've allotted for us this side of heaven. The time, God, that you've set aside. Because the Bible says life, this life is as a vapor. It is here today and gone tomorrow. Lord, I remember when my babies was just little. I remember an old van driving up and down the road. It seemed like it was yesterday. But it was a long time ago. God help us today. Just touch God's people, touch Brother John. As we pray for him and anoint him today. God, that you'd lead him and guide him, that you'd always just lean on you. Just lean on you. God, that's easy preaching today, but that's hard living. God, help us just to read our Bible and just study and show ourselves a good workman. Lord, that's easy preaching sometimes. Lord, it's hard living sometimes because we have to deal with this stuff called flesh. Lord, we say we're filled with the Holy Ghost. But sometimes our flesh overrides the power that lives inside of us. Help us to access that power on a regular basis. Paul said to crucify this flesh daily. Help us to crucify this old flesh daily. And lean not on our own understanding, but God lean upon you. I pray, God, for the remainder of this day, God, that you bless us. God, bless every church that's represented here, the preachers that are here, the evangelists, God. God, whatever ministry, God, that you allotted for them in this side of heaven, God, I pray, Father, that they use that time and the talents and the gifts, God, that you bless them with for the glory and the honor of God. Lord, we love you and we'll thank you for all that you do. In Christ's name, I pray. God's people say. Brooke, all you preachers, I don't care if you're laughing or you're not. All right? Brother John, why don't you come up here? Bring your Bible. We'll put your needle right here. We're going to get around here and we're going to play over you. It's a great time of honor. Brother John. There's not going to be a lot of money, I assure you. But the benefits is out of this world. Let's pray. Father, Lord Jesus, we anoint Lord Jesus, Brother John, for all of this brother. I pray, Father, that you illuminate his mind. God, I pray, Father, that you open the door, God, that you open the door. Well, John was one of the churches that I pastored. He helped me a lot. He was a real blessing. He's come a long way, and I just want to thank his family for being here. You guys are the ones that's going to have to stand behind him and love him and support him. And that's really what it takes. It takes a family, and it takes friends. You know, the preachers pray for him. God with him.
All right. Y'all sing, I can't stand here. I'm going to
be on the ground today, or I'm going to go through that trailer.
Don't fall, because I will.
I know you will.
I'm not sure y'all are right. Don't let him lie
to
you. All right. All right. Well, like I say again, it's good to be back. Amen. And have you enjoyed the service last night?
Amen.
Amen. I tell you what, God moved last night. Amen. So we're going to do this. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer. I think we'll have some more people coming in. It's sun shining, and last night it was too dark, and today it's too bright. So, whatever, amen. All right, we're going to bow our heads and go to the Lord in prayer, and then we're going to get started. Brother Mike Rowe, would you come and pray for us, please?
Our dear and gracious Heavenly Father, Lord God, we thank you, Lord, for another opportunity, Lord, we have to meet here together. God, I thank you for the service last night. Thank you, Lord, for how you showed up, how you moved and touched and blessed those that were here last night. God, I thank you, Lord, for what's already taking place here. And God, I pray that you just be with Brother John, continue to touch him and help him, Lord, as Lord now being ordained and as he furthers his ministry. God, I pray that you be with him every step of the way. God, I just pray, Lord God, you meet with us here today. God, I pray that you bless the singing, the fellowship. God, I pray that you bless the preaching of your word today. God, I pray that you give us all that which we stand in need of. Father, you know what each and every one of us need on a personal level. And God, you are our personal Savior. And so, God, I pray that you give us, each and every one of us, Lord, what we need. God, I pray that we get it today. God, I pray that we grasp hold of it and apply it to our lives. And God, I pray this above everything. If there's somebody here today that's lost on their way to hell, Lord, I pray they hear the gospel and take heed to it and get saved today before it's eternally too late. God, I pray that you meet with us here today. Have your will and your way. In Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Y'all ready? All right. We're going to get the Fraley's to come on. Amen. So you pray for them. Amen. What'd y'all pick him to out? Hitchhiking? They do. Amen. All right. You pray for them.
Stop singing, then the joy bells start ringing, then the cry of heaven when the saints go marching in.
Won't that be a happy evening when we step on the other side? When the saints of old stand with the green to welcome us across the tide, we'll lift that dance together, both shouting all through the land. And when you think it's just
I've got a way down deep salvation like no mortal tongue can tell. And we'll stand an invitation to a hallelujah spell.
Won't that be a hallelujah ring when we step on the other side? When the saints of old stand with the green world and march across the tide. We'll lift our hands together, Lord, shout all through the land. And when you think it's just about it, it'll happen all over again. Won't that be a hallelujah ring when we step on the other side? When the saints of old standing with the green world and march across the tide. We'll lift our hands together, Lord, shout all through the land. And when you think it's just about it, it'll happen all over again. And when you think it's just about it, it'll happen all over again.
Check. Now cut me down, because I'm going to chop everybody's head off here in a second.
Nothing's on?
Check.
All right. Her mic needs to be louder. She's kind of deep. Sure.
And now we have CD player problems.
It's alright. Don't worry about it. Ain't nothing but a thing. Nothing but a chicken wing.
Now what do you say? I spoke up, Your Honor. I have no defense, but that's when mercy walked in. Mercy walked in and pleaded my case, called to the stand, God's saving grace. The blood was presented that covered my sin, forgiven when mercy walked in. I stood there in wonder, how could this be, that someone so guilty had just been set free. My chains were broken.
Yeah.
I felt born again. The moment that mercy walked in. Oh, mercy walked in and pleaded my case. Called to the stand. God saving grace. The blood was presented that covered my sin. Forgiven when mercy walked in. The blood was presented that covered my sin. Forgiven when mercy walked in.
Ever made me, I love him. That's all I want to say.
Well, the king told Daniel not to pray to his God anymore. I'll lock you in the lion's den and throw away the key to the door. The very next day they found Daniel down on his bending knees. Came up all the different this time he opened the blind so the whole wide world could see.
I don't care what you say, I'm gonna pray anyway. I'm gonna lift my hands up to the Lord for the things he's done for me. I just gotta get away, find a place to seek his face. I don't care what you say, I've got a right to pray.
Anybody believe that here today? Well, they tell our children not to pray when they walk through the schoolhouse door. According to the Constitution, they can't do that anymore. Well, I wonder what old Daniel would say if he was alive today. If the judge declared no more prayer, I believe he would say,
hey, I don't care what you say, I'm gonna pray anyway. I'm gonna lift my hands up to the Lord for the things he's done for me. I just gotta get away, just find a place to see his face. I don't care what you say, I've got a right to pray. I don't care what you say, I'm gonna pray anyway. I'm gonna lift my hands up to the Lord for the things he's done for me. I just gotta get away, find a place to see his face. I don't care what you say, I've got a right to pray. I don't care what you say, I've got a right to pray.
Oh yes, we all. As a redneck Christian boy, I got a right to pray. Amen. One more? Five. Four, five, six, or eight.
We're here all day.
I didn't know who was a preacher. Who was a preacher first? Who was a preacher last? You're a preacher. All CDs and all.
I'm unworthy to call upon your name. All my life I've been a sinner, and for that I am ashamed. But I heard that you would listen, so I'm giving you my plea. Too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me?
I know that there are others who could offer more than I promise you I'd understand if for me you have no time. I think I just hit bottom, and I'm looking up to see.
I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me? Guess I must be reaping from the seeds that I have sown.
owe me nothing. We haven't spoken for so long. But if you could spare some mercy, I'll pledge my life to thee. I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me?
If for me I had no time, I think I'll just hit bottom and look it up to see.
I'm too unworthy, Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down? Could you please come down? Come down to me.
Used to doing most of these songs with the two of them because Hannah usually does them, so I'm still looking lost today. For those of you who don't know, these are two of the four of our children. Amanda's right there. Wave your hand, sweetheart. That's Leah. Everybody who usually has seen her with a passy in her mouth, and that's the first thing Brian Austin said yesterday. The first thing Brother Randy said today was, I used to steal your passy.
Not recently.
Yeah, she's 14 and a half now. And she's a little bit grown up on us, so give her a hand, please. Well, both of them together. This is Jacob. He's 18 years old. He is recovering from total ACL reconstruction surgery in January and has missed the spring semester of college, but we're hopefully going to ship him back out in the fall. And so y'all pray for his recovery. But this is Jacob Austin Fraley. Missing Hannah. She's 17 and she's our blonde bombshell, and if you ever meet her, you'll never forget her. And those of you who know her understand that. But y'all pray for her because one of her classmates committed suicide Wednesday night, and it's really taking a toll on all of them. But as we were talking about earlier, you know, it sort of puts everything in a new perspective. You realize what's important to you, what should be important to you, and the things that did matter don't matter a whole lot anymore. But family and friends and the things that are eternal, because everything on this earth is just wood, hay, and stubble, and it's going to burn up. But it's the things eternal that are going to matter and that are going to last a lifetime. You know, we were talking about, you know, I wonder when I die, if it were to be today, the kinds of crowns that I would have to give back to the Lord. You know, I don't know what I would have, and I don't. It's never going to be enough. But God helped me to keep my eye on that prize of being able to give back to Him all that I possibly can. Because He is worth so much more than what I've done for Him. He's worth so much more.
Well, put in, if anybody has an offline. Okay, well then.
I want
And since you're doing such a good job.
Just like your past,
We've been giving him a hard time about his ties, because yesterday it was that it was on the hanger. It wasn't on the hanger. It was in the trailer. This morning he couldn't find one to match that shirt, and he kept trying to wear a red one. It doesn't match the shirt. So we've been giving him a hard time. And now we're trying to find a CD, because we're trying to let the kids sing as much as possible, because I'm about sung out. So, and we're trying to find this song for Jacob.
Looked inside and saw his bones. Traveled on to see Muhammad, still wrapped up in his grave clothes. Then I journeyed to a garden where old Joseph left him laid, the precious lamb, God's own begotten, was no longer in that grave. If you knew him like I know him, you would know that he's alive. If you felt him like I feel him, resurrection deep inside, you know he's living and death has died. If you're wandering in the darkness, come and step into the light. Nail-scarred hands reach out to help you, to hold you safe from death to life. Friend, I too have stood where you stand. Could I trust in thee? But just one step in his direction, then in love he ran to me. Yeah, oh, like I know him, you would know that alive. If you felt him like I feel him, resurrection deep inside, you know he's living and it has died. You are inside, you know he's living
headline reads, disaster strikes once more. The writing on the wall is just too great to be ignored. Floods and earthquakes everywhere, violence plagues our land. The last days are upon us, Christ's coming is at hand. Where would you be had Jesus come back 5 minutes ago? Would you still be here, alone and lost without hope? He will return as a thief in the night. Will you be taken or left behind? Where would you be had Jesus come back 5 minutes ago? This lost and dying world must face the judgment seat one day. They're hanging in the balance for this crime they must pay. Refusing to accept God's grace, how could they be so blind? The sand is quickly pouring through the hourglass of time. Where would you be had Jesus come back 5 minutes ago? Would you still be here, alone and lost without hope? Stop or change God's plan. The prophecies have been fulfilled. He's coming back again. Where would you be had Jesus come back 5 minutes ago? Would you still be here alone and lost without hope?
Amen. If you enjoyed that, say amen.
Amen.
All right, I'm going to get you to do something. I'm going to get you to stand, stretch your legs, and I'll get two guys to get up here. Amen. Okay, one, two. One, one, two. Okay. All right, we're going to take up an offering, and I had you stand up so you get to your billfolds. Amen. But we're going to take up an offering, and anything you give goes towards Brother Fraley and Brother Fletcher and them for coming. Amen. We appreciate them coming. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So we're going to do this, and while you stretch your legs, can you play something? You going to play some? And then when they get back, just turn around and shake hands and stretch your legs a little bit, and then we'll get right back into it, okay? All right. I better pray for it happening. Father, thank you, Lord, for this time of giving. I pray, God, you bless today, Father. God, you know the needs here, Father. We'll thank you, and we'll love you. And we'll praise you, for the name of Lord Jesus Christ we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Time Fellowship. Seat back, we'll go ahead and tell it. All right, go ahead and sit down. Try to be nice. Say, find your seat. So get back to Sam. All right. How many's glad you came today? Amen. I know it's in the middle of the day. Amen. But I'm glad you found time to come. Amen. All right. It was requested last night. I didn't know it. Sister Dawn, come on up here and sing that song. Amen. Oh, man. Then when she gets through, Steve, y'all be ready, okay? All right. Hey, I'm going to share something with you. I got a phone call this morning about 8:30, and there's a man that lives in Bessemer City. He walks the streets. And one of the members here gave me my phone number, and he called me. His name's Tommy. Tommy has lung cancer, and he lives by himself. He said he's never been married. He said he had to make a decision about this lung cancer, and somebody stood in for him Wednesday night at the church. But he said that he heard this church had been praying for him. But the reason I'm telling you this, we need to pray for him. Amen. Amen. He's got to make a decision. He said the doctors told him if he did chemo, he still probably wasn't going to cure it. But if he didn't take it, then he certainly wasn't going to get any better. And he said, but I'm just going to trust in the Lord. So he said, you think it's wrong if I just trust in the Lord? I said, no, I think it's the best thing you can do is trust in the Lord. So anyway, I'm putting his name out here for all you people here. Y'all pray for Tommy. Amen. He's concerned enough about it to call and ask for prayer. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Ah, you pray this morning tonight and what day it is.
Heal your hurting soul.
Amen. If you enjoy this, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to get the Fletchers to come on. You know, I want to thank God for the Fletchers. They've been here for us when nobody else was. I know the second Sunday that we had service here was in October. We didn't have any heat.
Amen.
Didn't have the money to turn the heat on. They said that's the coldest they ever been in their life, serving the Lord. But you know what? They came anyhow, and they come every homecoming, and every camp, and just anything we have, and we invite them, they're there, and I thank God for them, amen. And boy, y'all here? Ain't nobody saying a word. All right, you pray for them as they come.